I'm going to show you three different scenes from Werner Herzog's documentaries, and I want you to guess what they all have in common. The first is from The White Diamond and this beautiful shot of a waterfall. The second is the ending of Cave of Forgotten Dreams with these crocodiles that have been mutated from the radioactive water of a power plant. And lastly, this scene of researchers listening to seal calls through the ice and encounters at the end of the earth. The answer is, in fact, these shots have been faked or staged in one way or another. The droplet in the first clip is a glycerin shot to better refract light. The crocodiles are naturally albino alligators from Louisiana with no radiation in their enclosure. And the final scene was directed by Herzog with the sound added in post-production. Werner Herzog has always been an interesting filmmaker to me, not just because of his film's recurring themes of man versus nature and obsession, but what really interests me is his use of less traditional documentary filmmaking techniques and utilization of fabrication and rehearsal. Whilst on a surface level it seems easy to place his films under the docudrama genre, the fact that the recreated scenes aren't intrinsically obvious makes us different altogether. Even Herzog himself has called his documentaries feature films in disguise. The frequent use of invention in his docos is what Herzog calls the ecstatic truth, which he explained the principles of in 1999. Some of these including facts create norms and truth illumination, and that a poetic ecstatic truth can only be reached through fabrication, imagination, and stylization. Herzog rejects pure fact for narrative and visual poetry. In short, he lies to tell the truth. So how does this ethos work in Herzog's documentaries? Although Herzog's films often feature massive landscapes and the ferocity and beauty of nature, his films are more interested in the human side of the story. Unlike most nature-focused docos, where people are used to tell stories about the bigger picture, Herzog uses the bigger picture to tell stories about us. Landscapes are often the forefront, which while distancing us from the humanity of his stories, it also allows us to be more introspective and observant of the people in these films. Herzog will often use staging combined with the environment to create occasionally unsubtle visual metaphors, emphasizing what a subject is saying, such as this scene from The White Diamond, where Graham Dorrington is awkwardly placed next to a river, reflecting on death on a reflective surface. Another type of staging Herzog frequents in is scripting and rehearsal. Not only in some cases will he write dialogue for his subjects to say, but he will even incorporate multiple takes of an interview or stage scene until he is satisfied. This is usually done for narrative purposes, as a way to deliver exposition to the audience without the use of voiceover. But Herzog has also written people's descriptions of events that have happened to them. Not changing the events, mind you, but creating a more engaging and poetic dialogue for the audience. While this does seem like an inherently lazy way to deliver information to the audience, Herzog exploits the fact that his subjects aren't actors to find something real in his fakery. Let's watch this scene from Grizzly Man.
Jewel, I apologize that this wristwatch is still in an evidence bag. However, I want you to have this watch. I think that it is important that you have it. You knew Timothy for a long time. My understanding is that you lived together for 3 years. You were very close to him.
Yeah, he was my boyfriend for 3 years. He was my boss. He was a lot of things to me in 20 years.
Yeah, I understand that. And that's the reason I want you to have this. This really should be yours.
An obviously staged scene, it's done to show the relationship ex-girlfriend Jewel Palovac has with the film's main deceased subject, Timothy Trevor. It feels unnatural to rehearse, doesn't it? But whereas most directors would cut when the scene finishes, Herzog still films, and with no given direction, subjects don't know what to do. And what do we get out of it?
The last thing that's left.
A slice of truth, a reaction we couldn't have gotten otherwise. This technique can be seen throughout a lot of Herzog's documentaries as a way to naturally show a vulnerable side to the people in front of the camera. But the most prominent use of his ideology is to evoke a theme or mood from his work. In Little Dieter Needs to Fly, Herzog manufactures this scene of POW survivor Dieter Dengler of habitually opening and closing doors to his car and home multiple times. A habit he apparently formed for being unable to open his prison door for so long. But in the next scene in Dieter's house, what do we see? Endless paintings of open doors. This scene wasn't set up. Dieter wasn't even aware of owning so many paintings of doors, only buying them because they were cheap. Herzog was able to create a thematic through line of Dieter's appreciation of freedom through this staging. Infamously, this quote from philosopher and mathematician Blaise Pascal, Lessons of Darkness opens with, was in fact written by Herzog himself. The quote, and the name attached, is designed to give a highbrow sense of what the film has in store, and manipulates the audience's mood into a more somber one. And while some of these methods seem hackneyed and manipulative, isn't this at its heart what filmmaking is? Manipulation of actors, a manipulation of sound, a manipulation of images to manipulate an audience into finding truth from something? Even more conventional documentary forms, where real footage can be easily manipulated, the only truth that can be found is in the editing suite. To me, Herzog's practices aren't lies to deceive, but stylistic tools to craft a bigger, more interesting story. His films aren't a pursuit of definite facts, but an exploration of humanity. On a final note, the use of reconstruction is also used to emphasize another common theme in Herzog's body of work, the barriers of communication within people. Whether it's language, technology, or disability, it's apparent in Herzog's work that it's his belief that artistic expression is transcendent of communication. And despite his dislike of cinema verite and other more typical documentary forms, I think Herzog believes that the only true way of growth, expression, and seeking truth is through art. After all, what have you learnt more about yourself from? A film based in fiction, or a film based in fact?